In this tutorial, I'm going to show you an exciting new feature we've added to the BuddyBoss Plus plan, Cloudflare Media Offloading. With this feature, you can automatically offload images, videos, and documents from your WordPress site to Cloudflare, taking advantage of their fast CDN and secure storage. This means your site will run faster, videos will stream smoothly, and you won't have to worry about large media files slowing down your community. Let's dive into the backend settings and see how it works. Before we get started, please note that this feature is available as part of the BuddyBoss Plus plan. Once you've purchased the Plus plan, download the BuddyBoss Offload Media plugin from your BuddyBoss account. Then, from your WordPress dashboard, go to Plugins and install and activate the plugin. Next, go to BuddyBoss, Integrations, Cloudflare. Here, we'll need to connect your Cloudflare account to BuddyBoss. To do that, we will need to enter our Cloudflare account ID and account API token. I'm now logged into my Cloudflare account under the account homepage. From here, click the ellipsis next to your account name and take note of your account ID. We'll need this later. Next, click your profile icon in the upper right corner, then click Profile. Go to the API Tokens tab and click Create Token. Scroll down and click Get Started next to Custom Token. Enter a name for this token. Now let's add multiple permissions so we can use the same token for everything we need it for. First, select Account, then Account Settings, and choose Read. Next, click Add More, select Account again, then choose Cloudflare Images, and select Edit. Add another permission, select Account, then Stream, and choose Edit. You should now have a total of 3 permissions added here. Optionally, you can set an expiration date for this API token under TTL. Once you're done, click Continue to Summary, then click Create Token. Take note of this token, and let's head back to our BuddyBoss site. Under Global Settings, paste your account ID and account API token, then click Verify. Once verified, Global Settings is now connected. Still under Global Settings, you can enable the option to remove local media from the server after uploading to Cloudflare. Next, under the dropdown for browser TTL, choose how long images will stay in the browser cacher. You can select anywhere from 2 days up to 1 year. And finally, select which media you want to offload. Simply check the options you want, then click Save Settings. Next, we'll move on to the image configuration section. For the key token, enter the same account API token you created earlier. Now, let's head back to Cloudflare. Make sure your account is selected, then from the left sidebar, go to Media, Images, Hosted Images, Keys tab. Copy the API token from this page, then paste it into the signed token field in BuddyBoss. Click Verify. Under this section, you can also enable the option to serve from custom domain. This allows your media files to be delivered through your own domain instead of the default Cloudflare or BuddyBoss URL. You can also enable the option to offload non-compliant images to R2. Once everything is configured, click Save Settings to apply your changes. Now, let's move on to the video configuration section. For the Stream API token, enter the same API token we used for the Account API and Image Key token. Then click Verify. Just like in the Image Configuration section, you also have the options to serve from custom domain and offload non-compliant videos to R2. Once you've set everything up, click Save Settings to apply your changes. For the last section we need to set up, let's configure documents. Go back to your Cloudflare account and make sure your account is selected at the top. Then navigate to Storage and Databases, R2 Object Storage. Overview. On this page, locate the Account Details section and click Manage. Next, click Create User API Token. Enter a name for this token. Under Permissions, select Admin Read and Write. Choose your preferred duration for this token. For now, I'll select Forever. Click Create to generate the token. Take note of your access key ID and secret access key, then paste them into the corresponding fields in BuddyBoss and click Verify. For the endpoint, you can leave it as default. For the public bucket, select the bucket you want to use for all default documents uploaded in the media section of the backend. For the private bucket, select the bucket to use for all BuddyBoss documents. And if nothing is selected, all files will be saved to the local server where your site is hosted. Once everything is set, click Save Settings to complete the setup. Once everything is connected and configured, you can start using the bulk management tools. With just a few clicks, you can offload all media, download all files from the bucket to your server, delete all files from the bucket, or delete all files from the server. These tools make it much easier to manage all your media and keep everything organized. Now let's see the feature in action. Whenever a user uploads an image to your site, whether it's in an activity feed, group, message, forum, or profile, BuddyBoss will automatically upload it to Cloudflare Images. For example, if someone uploads a photo in an activity post, the image is stored in Cloudflare Images, not on your server. The image is delivered according to your privacy settings. To verify, you can go to your Cloudflare account under Media, Images, Hosted Images, and you will see the uploaded image listed there. The same process applies to videos, which go to Cloudflare Stream, and documents, which go to Cloudflare R2. If media is ever deleted, BuddyBoss will also remove it from Cloudflare, keeping everything in sync automatically. So that's the new Cloudflare Media offloading feature in BuddyBoss. It's a simple, powerful way to keep your site fast, scalable, and secure, while giving your users a smooth experience when uploading or viewing media. If you found this tutorial helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe, and tap the notification bell so you never miss a BuddyBoss update. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next tutorial.